Captain John Kent came up with his very own strategy to vault the language barrier.
Aeroplane. Air-o-plane.
Samolotl.
Sam.
I had to learn some Polish.
Samolot.
I went round the aircraft giving English names for the various parts and getting the Polish in return.
Wing.
Skrzydła.
Skrzydło.
Gradually, I worked out a complete procedure in Polish and had it all written down phonetically on my knee pad. It worked very well and amused the Poles a lot.
Kent?
Yes.
No. Kentowski. Kentowski.
Hello engine lovers, diesel heads, vintage engine collectors all over the world, from Mexico to Australia to Spain and Poland. Today a special edition. It was a little bit quiet the last time, but I have so much to do and some things in my private life going not so well, so I have really no lot of time and setbacks, but I am back, as you see. And what we're gonna do today? Special one. Today we look at the Polish Jaskolka engines, as you know maybe. You have seen on my channel this beauty here. Jaskolka 1 from 1959. I'm really glad with this box because I love the boxes for my engines. And I have also the other ones from 1956 to 58. The early type Jaskolkas, like this one. And but today we will look at the engine what follows up this one. This is the induction rear valve induction with a clock valve. And after this came this engine, the Type 2. Because this is a plain bearing engine and this is a ball bearing engine. But the induction is the same type. And later in 1962, my year of birth, I have this lovely 2.5 class reference book. You will see it looks similar, but it's a disc rotary valve version. So this I sadly don't have yet, but I'm sure my Polish friend Marcin Sadowi will take a good care of it and watch out for it. And today we're gonna take care of this beauty. This is the same engine like this one, of course, and I found this year, finally after a couple years of looking, and short after this, Marcin find this one for Adrian Duncan, because he will be delighted to have this one, this type, but of course it needs a lot of work, a lot. As you see, the crank pin is, of the crank pin, the piston pin is so worn out, it hitches actually, it fools sometimes the transfer ports. It's a little bit corroded. The anodizing is of course very bad, misses the compression lever and the needle. Maybe the spray bar is also broken, not sure. Of course, clock valve don't work and bar bearings are toast. A little bit corroded here. But I think it's going to be a huge metamorphose. So if all goes well, it should look like this one. And I make a small video so you can take a look at this after this, the intro. And I was thinking it was a nice idea to make step by step this assembly of this engine, check the internal parts. I hope the piston pin don't fool the liner too much. If yes, I must grind it out anyway, make a new piston, oversize, check the valve, because on my engine this reed valve was also damaged. Somebody take a screwdriver of something and damage the membrane, so I make a new membrane. And this will be quite a challenge. Maybe, I don't know if you can see this, but there's a ring with four pins inside. I have to take later photos of it. I make a simple tool, so I can open up this. It's like an adjustable wrench. I make parallel needle rollers in, bigger and smaller size, so I can go inside here, take the Ventura first out, and then open up the cover. Like this, very simple, but pretty effective. So that's it. I have no idea how tight everything is. I will heat it up first. The first thing will be to put down the probe driver or the head, doesn't matter. And when the head is down, I take a spring collet from my lathe and grab on the top of the cylinder, heat it up, and I hope it will come down. And then I can check how bad it really is. I will polish, of course, everything will nicely polished. A little bit corrosion. But all these Jaskolka engines are not cast very smooth. Everybody have, every engine has a little bit raw cutter from the casting, it's sound cast. But I will smooth out this a little bit because it must be top of the notch. And it will be, trust me. So, let's go. Давай! See you soon. Okay, so I got my gloves, heavy leather gloves. Put this nice Elia on the way, it's so beautiful, but it's actually too big for my running stand. I must make some clamp to hold it, otherwise I cannot run it. It's so lovely. So many things to do and so little time. I've got this burner to heat it up, and this, as I told you, a 70 millimeter collet. I make myself an on the lathe and collet holder. And this slips nice tight over the cylinder. I need a pin so I can hold it tight. Yep. And I really need to tie that very well. Usually I hold this together like this so it will not slip. I have good grip and then try to open it up. Okay, heat is the next thing. If this will not work, I will put it in VD40, heat it up slowly, wait a little bit and try again. Of course now I must be careful, because if the pin fools already the port and I try to twist, sorry, I must be careful, because if the pin, wrist pin is already in the port and I try to twist, I will damage the conrod. So I must be sure it's free, and it is right now. Okay, heat. Just the aluminium part, not the steel part, because aluminium expands 2-3 times so much as the steel. And there's of course also the castor oil. Okay, should be enough. Okay. Oops. These heavy gloves, I have no feeling in it. And let's go. Yes! It's really surprisingly going well so far. There you have it. And with this, you have really no chance of damaging the piston of the liner for distortion. Soon I will take the contact piston out and check the liner inside the bore. This is it. Okay. It's a badly bent, chewed up conrod. This is really... Yeah, I think we need a replacement. Piston and gasket, what's left over. Okay, and now we must take down the the proper college. Dry washer. It's not pretty hot. I hope you can see me, what I'm doing. Okay, I will heat up the prop driver again so it will expand. I will anodize anything anyway, everything, so I don't care about this color now. But usually it's through feel light, not the heat, what turns the color away. Okay. Yeah, there you go. See how easy it is? Now we see also here the paper gasket, also the cone. Oh. This will also need replacement because it's so important that they use in these days open bearings with no rubber seals. So I've replaced the bearings with versions at least on the front with a rubber seal, and I removed the inner seal so it will get lubricated. Okay, let's go easy. Now we need to take the crankshaft out, because pretty easy so far. Always I screw a nut on it to prevent damaging the thread. This is a stainless steel nut, so it can take some punch. Small hammer and maybe a rule. So I have my leg here, so here I can punch pretty good. But I must be careful because this is not flat as you see. So better is put him like this, so the whole cutter will support. Yep. It is easier than I was really. Just a little bit more. And the cutter was a little bit corroded on the downside, on the underside. So I will grind the sandpaper and file the worst stuff out. And I have a small, I don't know if you can see this, I have a small sandblasting cabinet here. It's from a dental labor for teeth, and this is give me a nice satin finish with soda blasting. Lucky today. Bearings are really badly worn. A central bushing between the bearings. The crank pin itself is not all too bad, just a little bit polishing and using a lapping spring-loaded collet to make it a little bit cylindric again. This I make myself as well. Something like this. This is from Brassmade. Cut four slots and a spring loaded. Also for outer segments. And this is cylindric, and this you can push over the crank pin and electric drilling machine and ground it with diamond compound to the cylindric shape again. Take the grooves out and make it a little bit smaller, but I make a new connecting rod anyway, so it will fit nicely again. Okay. This bearing feels not really bad, but I must take it out for sure. I make from old engine, car engines valve. I cut off the valve itself. This is excellent steel, so I make it in several diameters so I can punch, use it as a punch. It's still warm, so it should come out very easily. Yep, there it is. it fall down somewhere and I'm lost it. Okay. Oh, here, got it. Okay. We have the Askolka in pieces. Some remaining carta. Maybe you can see this damage. But like I say earlier, it is a pretty rough sound casting. I will try to keep the SG2.5 and the Askolka Romanic 2 visible, so I will not grind too much there. I will keep my work under the letters. And after sandblasting, I take waterproofs, like 1000 of something, and very slightly polish only the top of the letters, so it will come nicely forward, because now it's hardly to see. This is actually not damaged really, just the sandpapering and polishing, it will be like chrome very nicely. This is so a nice engine. The Aero Modella, I think it was, I believe, they tested this engine, and there was a report, and they say no other European engine makes so many O's and R's like this Jaskolka, because it was so nice, bright polished exhaust ring. And the red, and this is polished, it's really beautiful engine, and it is. Because if you look at this one, it's really beautiful, man, beautiful. Later they have to change the exhaust ports, like a Typhoon Blizzard, the Mark 1. A little bit oval, not square, but oval. And the Type 3 has also oval with the rotor disc. Yeah, but it's really a beautiful engine, really like it. This was almost as bad as this one. I found this on eBay in the UK. Very strange, but it was in the UK. Okay, I will try to take care of the cutter. As you see, it's really... could be worse, but it's not good either. So I will carefully try out to get rid of this oxidation. Carefully under the letters, but not too smooth. As I told before, it is some casting, so it should be a little bit rough. Some nicks here. Okay, I'll make later a picture. So I clean it up a little bit raw, the worst stuff. Still some very deep pits, but if I will file this down, it will be too thin. So I must make a compromise here, but I buy this nice set to make cups and round shapes from metal. But I find out you can use these hard and nice ball ends to simulate casting pits. So I will do like this with several sizes, and you will get very nice small pits on it. So you get an equal structure. It will look like sand casting, and then I will blast it with soda and it will be okay. So just to get the worst pits a little bit egalized. Just very slightly, but it will leave a very small thin impact. Like this is spherical, but of course very very small. And then you will get the impression it's again a sand casted, raw sand casting. But it will take a while. I will come back. So after some 10 minutes you can see a little bit of difference. I hope the camera takes it. Left, the right side is shiny, but the other side is uniform with very small pits. So I think if it will sandblast it later on, it will be very nice. You will hardly recognize the cutter anymore. Of course this is not correct. You see the corrosion pits and smooth from filing and grinding, polishing. So it has to be casting structure like this. This is perfect. It's just the idea I found out, it works pretty well. And try to keep the seam from the casting, of course. Okay, let's do the other side and I can insert the blasting. I clean also up a little bit here. Must still use the rods, smaller rods to... and also you bend, this is like a crater. You bend slightly the sharp edges inwards, so you get more uniform structure. Needs a little bit practice, but it will be okay. Because this is really almost like ordinary. Only sandblasting. Okay.
So, I am back.
As you see, the underside is pretty neat now. Still got my casting edge. And I cleaned up also the top a little bit. And now I will solar blast it to make it one unanime consistent outside. And I will show you later on you how it looks. So I go inside. Hoover. So I did some polish work and clean it up, and it's far better as it was. Especially the downside was really very bad, and I'm really pretty happy. Yeah, it's not so bad. I was really worried, and it's pretty badly corroded, but it will be come off with the diamond file very easy because it's hardened, and then polish with is always bergum. It's for aluminium, but it's for steel also working very well, as it gives a really very nice smooth polish. So now I will clean this inside and outside up, so I can take a really good look, because now it's dirty and I'm not sure if it's no corrosion or if it's old castor oil. So I have to really clean this up, and I can examine this very well. And I also take my inside micrometer and check the taper. It's very important, of course, by a diesel engine. So as you see, there are slightly corrosion marks from, I think, amyl nitrate or moisture, but no score marks of the piston pin or piston or whatever, so that's a good sign. So light lapping and it will be fine. Oversized piston, and I have also here some notches and some small marks, but you can, the same with the head anodizing, you can choose to remove material, but you will change the sizes. So maybe I will go down a little bit further, but some like this one, this is too deep, so I will have to live with that, because I don't want to change the appearance of the engine. So yeah, it is a very old engine, 60 plus years, and it had a hard life, but in the end it will be much better. See the pits a little bit. Yeah, it will run still fine because it's another score downwards, and it will leak, but this will not leak, but it will keep the oil anyway. But I will still make a hone, or I think I have a 14 or 15 millimeter hone, 14.5, and this will be erased, or almost erased, so it will be no problem for the run and for the seal. Okay, so far the cylinder checkup, and I will only measure it up now. So I take the internal sizes from the cylinder, and it's about 0.03 millimeter from under the contour piston, from above the exhaust ports, and it's pretty much, it's really pretty much. And even down there is even much more. So it will need to be grind out a lot, and it's about 1.5, max 2 from complete down to tether save will be nice, to have a nice compression seal, and when the piston goes down. The Russian MK17 take this filler to the max. They have maybe only 0.01 from the top to the down, so you have the tremendous cutter pressure. But the bad side is after some running time, the seal is not on top good enough, because the taper is gone. So it just has to be slightly more taper, and still have a good cutter seal to get a good starting engine and good powerful engine. So I will need to grind out with my grinding arbor pretty much material to make it first nice cylindric taper,
and light a little bit taper. Yeah, maybe I will try to put a little bit down, a little bit much more grinding the outer exhaust flange, because there's really some nasty cuts here and that spoils really the image, but not too much. But this one will be not gone, it's really far too deep. But the lighter ones, they will be gone. So I will try this first. So, let's go on grinding. It can take some time because I must grind a lot. I start on the top because it's really far smaller on the top than below. I think this will be a 1.5 to 2 hour job to get it really perfect as I want it. A nice smooth finish and slight taper. So I will come, and come back when it's ready. Oil. That thing, I think it's enough. Slightly more. Chew it up a little bit, top then center the most load, so it's a little bit deeper here, but it's slowly coming, getting better. That thing, I think it's enough. Thank you. helicopter is cleaned up with ultrasonic bath. Conrad is together, I buy new bearings. So everything is progressing very nicely. And now it's slowly time to anodize this head and spinner. So everything can be put together. And slowly we can see the end line of the project. Now I will clean this up with a file and sandpaper. They are not bent, thanks a little bit here, not a lot. So I will straighten them up as good as I can with the knife, as I showed you before. And then do the best of it. This is not too bad, thanks God. This also not. This needs a little bit of work. So,
thank you.
Perfecto.